Hi, my name is Mini Sethi. Today we are going to learn about theory of unbalanced growth. This theory is propounded by Albert Hirschman, and other supporter of these theory are H.W. Singer, C.P. Kindleberg, Paul Streeten, and W.W. Roster. Okay, what is mean by unbalanced growth theory? According to unbalanced growth theory, we should not invest in all sector at same time. This is development strategy for underdeveloped country, because underdeveloped countries suffer from lack of resources. These countries don't have enough resources. That's why it is not possible for these countries to invest in all sector at same time. Okay, these countries should invest in leading sector only. Okay, it will automatically increase investment in other sector. Okay, in short, we can say that unbalanced growth theory is development strategy for underdeveloped country, because they don't have enough resources. They cannot invest in all sector at same time, so they should invest in one sector at one time, and it will automatically increase investment in other sector. Okay, these theory talk about two type of series: convergent series and divergent series. What does mean by convergent series? Convergent series says that sources of investment comes from private sector. Okay, convergent series says that sources of investment comes from private sector. On the other hand, divergent series says that sources of investment comes from public sector, or we can say that sources of investment comes from government sector. Okay, these theory classify investment into two types. Okay, first is social overhead capital, which we can say that SOC. Other is direct productive activity, which we can say that DPA. Okay, what does mean by SOC? SOC means expenditure on roads, irrigation, power, transport, and communication. Okay, these investment is done by government. Okay, on the other hand, if we are talking about DPA, okay, DPA is investment on manufacturing, investment on agriculture, investment on shopping complex, trade, tourism, and these done by private sector. Okay, SOC is done by government sector and DPA is done by private sector. Okay, as we earlier discussed, underdevelopment country don't have enough resources. Underdevelopment country cannot invest in both sector at same time. So underdevelopment country should invest in one sector at one time, and it will automatically increase investment in other sector. We will understand it with example. For example, government of underdeveloped countries providing electricity at cheap rate. Government of underdeveloping countries providing electricity at cheap rate. Okay, it will encourage growth of small scale industry. Okay, because of electricity, growth of small scale industry increase. Okay, electricity is part of SOC. Government did investment in SOC, but it automatically increase growth of small scale industry, which is part of DPA. On the other hand, if we do investment in manufacturing, okay, we are doing more manufacturing activities, we are doing more production. For implementing these manufacturing activity, we need transportation, we need communication, we need power. Okay, and these manufacturing activity automatically will increase investment in power, transportation, and communication. Okay, manufacturing activity is part of a DPA, but it automatically increase investment in SOC. Okay, so we can say that underdevelopment country should do investment in one sector, and it will automatically increase investment in other sector. We will understand the same concept with the help of diagram. Okay, at O axis, x axis, we are taking investment in SOC. In OY, in Y axis, we are taking investment in DPA. Okay, and this OR line is balancing line. Okay, in this line, all point is equal to SOC and DP. Okay, this line basically describe balance, describe equality between SOC and DP. Okay, in this line, all point represent SOC is equal to DP. Okay, these are isoproductive curve. Okay, these are isoproductive curve. Suppose we are in R point and government of underdeveloped country is doing investment in SOC and amount of investment is RM. Okay, RM investment is done by government of underdeveloped country on SOC. Okay, these investment automatically increase investment in DPA. And amount of investment is increased by SOC in DPA is RK. Okay, government did investment in SOC. RM amount of investment is done by government on SOC. And these investment automatically increase investment in DPA. And amount of investment is RK. Okay, investment in DPA will increase until balance will restored at S point. Okay, in S point SOC will equal to DPA. Suppose government is increasing more investment. Now we are in S point and government is increasing more investment on SOC, and in this time in amount of investment is SP. This amount of SP amount of investment on SOP again increased by government of underdeveloped country, and these investment automatically increase investment in DPA. Now amount of investment is SH. These investment done in SOC and these investment automatically increase investment in DPA is SH. ठीक है, एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट इन डीपी इज इंक्रीज अंटिल बैलेंस विल रिस्टोर इन एम पॉइंट. ओके, एम वन पॉइंट. ओके, ऑन द अनदर एंड वी कैन सिलेक्ट अदर पाथ. ओके, इंस्टेड ऑफ डूइंग इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ एसओसी वी कैन डू इन्वेस्टमेंट इन डीपीए. ओके, इन दिस टाइम गवर्नमेंट चूज डीपीए रेदर देन एसओसी. ओके, सपोज गवर्नमेंट डू इन्वेस्टमेंट इन डीपीए इज केआर, इट विल ऑटोमेटिकली इंक्रीज इन्वेस्टमेंट इन एसओसी आरएम, एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट इन एसओसी विल इंक्रीज अंटिल वी रीस्टोर बैलेंस एट एस पॉइंट. ओके, वेयर डीपीए इज इक्वल टू एसओसी. ओके, दिस इज ऑल अबाउट थ्योरी. वन मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट कॉन्सेप्ट आल्सो यूज इन दिस थ्योरी, दैट इज लिंकेज इफेक्ट. व्हाट डज मीन बाय लिंकेज इफेक्ट? दिस थ्योरी टॉक्स अबाउट टू टाइप ऑफ लिंकेज, बैकवर्ड लिंकेज एंड फॉरवर्ड लिंकेज. ओके, व्हाट डज मीन बाय बैकवर्ड लिंकेज? बैकवर्ड लिंकेज इंक्रीज इन्वेस्टमेंट इन अर्लियर स्टेज, एंड फॉरवर्ड लिंकेज इंक्रीज इन्वेस्टमेंट इन लेटर स्टेज. वी विल अंडरस्टैंड it with the help of example. Okay, firstly you understand the meaning. Backward effect increase investment in earlier stage, and forward linkage effect increase investment in later stage. For example country do investment in cocomas. Cocomas is most important material used for making chocolate. Okay, because of cocomas production of chocolate automatically increase. Okay, this is later stage, this is one stage ahead, this is called forward linkage. Okay, on the other hand, for doing investment in cocomas, for doing production in cocomas, we need cocoa butter. This is most important material used for making cocomas. Okay, because of cocomas automatically increase investment in cocoa butter. Okay, this is one stage earlier. Okay, this called backward linkage. Okay, this is one stage later, that's why it's called forward linkage, and this is one stage later, that's why it's called backward linkage. Okay, I think you got it. I think you understand it. Thank you.